as we saw in 2018, it covers the whole canal. It's really got me concerned because this is just the beginning of summer, and how long is this going to last?
Algae concerns in Cape Coral. Take a look at this. This canal off Del Prado Boulevard is coated with blue-green algae. And it's not just there. Other canals with bubble curtains are seeing it too. NBC2's Gina Tomlinson is live near Southeast 15th Avenue tonight investigating if these curtains are doing their job. Gina.
Christine, neighbors here tell me they're losing the fight to algae, even with the city's best weapon in place. They're wondering why the water in the canal you see behind me looks greener than ever before, if the bubbles are working.
This looks like the, you know, Chicago River when they throw the dye in it on St. Patrick's Day. I mean, it is that green.
Green slime covers the canal behind Ted Bond's home. He says now that the algae has been here for over a week, he's starting to wonder if it's not only the sight making him sick.
I don't usually have any troubles, but my chest is tight. My nose runs when I come down here. I'm feeling dizzy.
Others near his house on Southeast 37th Lane are wondering why waterways are green.
Been here 13 years, never seen a canal, this canal, in that shape.
After the city allocated $1 million for bubble curtains to fight off algae in the Cape.
Right now they're supposedly in place and it's not doing anything. So are they taking that $1 million and just throwing it in, down the sewer?
Our main exit out of the canal system does have a bubbler on it. You know, my thoughts are, you know, is it working, or maybe it's worse because once it starts, is it harder for this stuff to flush out?
Some neighbors also notice the bubbles aren't always on.
But if you turn them off, what have you done? You've allowed that flow to come back in. So why would you turn them off?
The city tells me the Army Corps orders the bubble curtains to turn on 5 hours before high tide and off 1 hour after high tide, allowing the tide to flush out the algae. They say the bubbles are working as expected, telling me that not all algae comes from the river and that residents could be contributing to the problem by using fertilizer.
They're telling people stop fertilizing. They're putting the bubblers in to try to stop, prevent the green algae, but I don't think any of it's working right now.
The city says they are continuing to mitigate the issue. In the meantime, they say to try not use fertilizer 15 feet from the water or before big storms. Live and local in Cape Coral, I'm Gina Tomlinson, NBC2.
Thank you, Gina.